Salutations, Celestial Sightseers. I'm David Fuller. Welcome to Eyes on the Sky. What's up this week? The moon is full on November 6th, so let's look at where all the planets may be seen in an extended version of Along the Ecliptic. Mercury was at greatest western elongation in the early eastern morning sky on November 1st. However, it's still visible quite easily for several more days early this week, and a couple bright stars can help you find it too. From mid-northern latitudes, on the morning of November 3rd, Arcturus, a bright zero-magnitude star, is up about 15 degrees elevation from the horizon an hour before sunrise. Mercury is about half as high from the horizon, approximately 25 to 30 degrees from the bright star. If you can't see it naked eye, try using binoculars. Mercury should not be any higher above the horizon than a full field of view at that hour. And a couple mornings later, on the 5th and 6th, Mercury will be nearly equal with the first magnitude Spica in Virgo. The planet will be the slightly brighter of the two. Just be sure to not use binoculars just before sunrise to avoid possible eye injury. Venus, on the other hand, is too close to the sun to see at the moment, but it's worth discussing. The former morning star has passed around the opposite side of the sun from Earth at Superior Conjunction on October 25th, and in about a month will be a very low bright spot on the evening western horizon after sunset. And looking about a light hour and a half past Venus is Saturn, the ringed planet that was in conjunction with the sun a week prior to Venus on October 18th. And the two planets appear to be going in opposite directions, Saturn moving westward and Venus moving eastward. That's because Earth is moving much faster than Saturn, leaving it behind, so to speak, while Venus moves faster than Earth and is catching up to Earth in its orbit. Along in late February, the brightening evening star will have caught up to the lazily moving Mars. And now this week's dark sky fact. Light pollution has an effect on most living things. Therefore, everyone benefits from understanding light more fully, both indoors and out. By pointing out that light harms our sleep and how that affects our circadian rhythm and naturally produced melatonin, I think we can make progress on changing minds about outdoor lights too. More to come in the near future on this. Please consider finding me at patreon.com to help contribute to this effort. Back to Mars. Though small, even now at 5.5 arcseconds of diameter, it sticks around low in the evening sky. Here it is this month, then in December, January, February, even March, settled in about 10 to 15 degrees up in the low evening sky. Keep observing it though. The more you view it now at a small angular diameter, the more you'll see when the red planet is next at opposition in May of 2016. 2016! Yes, quite a long time. So look at it now, even when it's small. It will help you better observe other planets too, such as Uranus. While not terribly large at just 3.5 to 4 arcseconds across, and completely featureless, Uranus is not much to see in a telescope. But it's still fun to observe the planet every now and again. Neptune, even smaller and farther away, is just 2.3 arcseconds of a tiny disk, requiring a lot of magnification and some steady skies. But both of these planets were highlighted a few weeks ago on Eyes on the Sky, and are well-placed for viewing right now. And lastly, Jupiter. The king of the planets is the largest of them, well, except for the thin arc of Venus when it's really close to us, and it offers up a lot of potential detail. Steady skies and larger aperture for better resolution are the keys to seeing more on it, but even very small telescopes can spy the two equatorial bands and 4 Galilean moons. Plus, it's up 15 degrees above the horizon by 1 a.m., so finish off an observing session by viewing it, or give the planet another couple weeks to rise to the same elevation by only midnight. Do you like these kinds of videos? Please subscribe, like, and/or follow. And thanks for watching. Keep your eyes on the sky and your outdoor lights aimed down so we can all see what's up. I'm David Fuller, wishing you clear and dark skies.